Hello everyone, my name is Laura Gómez Cuadrado and I am project manager at the University of Burgos, and I'm going to talk about project management models. What is project management? Project management is the application of methods, tools or techniques and competences to a project during its lifetime. It is also defined as the activities of planning, organizing, securing, monitoring and managing the resources and work necessary to deliver project goals and objectives in an effective and efficient manner. The Project Management Institute was founded in the United States in 1969. With the aim of fostering the use of common tools and techniques for managing, regardless of the sector they are applied to. And they developed a guideline called the Project Management Body of Knowledge that describes a set of standard methodologies and terminologies, practices and guidelines for project management. What can project management be used for? Project management can be used for internal and external meeting communications, for reporting and progress monitoring, both internal, this means within the consortium, or external to the European Commission. It can also be used for quality assurance and risk management, such as the organization of roles and responsibilities, timelines, outputs planning, quality reviews, and risk management. And also for conflict resolution. So by default, there are procedures that are provided by the consortium agreement, and they can be applied during the project management. And there are factors that are influencing the project performance and success. These are, for example, the environment, the strategy, the technology available, the maturity of the project management, resources that are available, and the organization and the structure. These are all factors that will influence in the execution and the quality of the project. And there is a methodology that was developed by the European Commission called PM Square. And this is a project management methodology that was developed in 2007 in order to manage EU projects. And it was made open access in 2018. The objective was to establish a common project management methodology that was open to all the European institutions, member states, contractors, and European citizens. It is an easy to implement methodology that aims to facilitate project managers to effectively manage and communicate their projects from the initiation until the closing of the project. And there is a center of excellence of the PM Square that provides top-notch project management infrastructure and guidance. And this enables a better and more efficient managing and communication of the project work. Also, this is supported by the project management information system that provides templates, instructions, and consolidates all the information for reporting and monitoring purposes. You can find the link below and with further information. And I will focus on two main points, which are for project management, which is the governance structure, the definition of roles and responsibilities, and also the importance of understanding the project lifecycle steps. With regards to the first point, the governance structure with the roles and responsibilities, these are the main teams that need to be defined for a project to be successful. To start with, we have the project coordination team, which is led by a scientific coordinator and a project manager. These are the people that have direct communications with the European Commission in order to lead the project. And the project coordination team has also a project support office, for example, the project transfer knowledge office or the financial office. Then we have the project steering committee, which is chaired by the project coordination team, and all the members of the project are involved in this committee. We have the advisory board, which is an external team that I will explain later on in more detail, and an exploitation and dissemination team with an innovation manager where all the partners are also involved, as well as the advisory board. And last but not least, we need to have a scientific and technical committee where the chair is the scientific coordinator and all the work package leaders within the project need to be involved for the project to be successful. Now I'm going to explain these roles in more detail. So the project coordinator team has the overall responsibility and management of the project. It consolidates the project planning, and it's the team that communicates and coordinates all the partners. This team monitors the scientific and technical progress of the entire project and is also in charge of handling the risk and applying contingency and mitigation plans. In terms of the project steering committee, it's a high-level management body of the project. And as I mentioned before, it's comprised by all the members of the consortium. And this is the committee that is taking all the decisions within the project, needs to comply with the grant agreement, and monitors the progress of the whole project. Then for the technical and scientific discussions, we have a specific committee called Scientific and Technical Committee. And as I mentioned before, it's comprised by all the work package leaders within the project to discuss the technical and scientific aspects and progress. It collects and constructs the scientific implementation of the project and elaborates recommendations to support the decision making. Another team that is extremely important within project management is the exploitation and dissemination team, which is in charge of the exploitation, dissemination, and communication activities, the promotion of the project, and the knowledge management and intellectual property rights. And finally, the advisory board is a top, is a team that is comprised by top-notch professionals that are closely related to the project thematic. And they have an external role, so they are not members of the project itself, but externally providing advice. They monitor the progress and they support in all the actions of the project, giving the advice of their expertise. And then we move on to the next step that I feel is like very important to, for a project to be successful, which is understanding all the steps that are necessary for a project to be completed and to be successful. So the steps are the initiating, planning, executing, and closing. And we need to understand who needs to be actively involved in each of these phases and which roles each of these members need to perform. If we start with the initiating phase, that will be later on explained in more detail by one of my colleagues, so you can check her video later on. This initiating phase is comprised by the project coordination team and the support office. During this phase, a project management manager is assigned and the scope of the project is defined. We need to identify what's the problem, which solution we want to implement, and what are the benefits from our project. Then we create a consortium from experts within this topic that we want to develop, and we select the roles and the stakeholders. And then the proposal writing starts. Then we move on to the next phase, which is the planning, where the project manager assigns a core team, which are technical and scientific experts. And also here we need to have the role of the exploitation and dissemination team, as well as the support office and of course the coordination team. In this phase, the project scope is elaborated. Definition of the timeline as well is assigned, and the work packages are properly described with deliverables, milestones, and key performance indicators or KPIs. The definition of the roles and responsibilities of the people involved as well is important within this phase. Once all this is defined, we move on to the executing phase. In the executing phase, it implies the coordination and implementation of the project. monitoring of the progress of the project, and also the identification of the risk and application of the contingency and mitigation plans. In this phase is where the coordination team needs to report the progress to the European Commission with deliverables, milestones, and technical and financial reports. And the last phase is the closing phase, where the European Commission has also a very important role. And we need to follow the recommendations provided within the project. And the aim here is to maximize the impact and exploitation activities. There will be a final report elaborated and evaluated by the European Commission and accepted by the stakeholders. There will be a final review meeting, and then we will proceed to the closure, administrative closure of the project. It is important to highlight that during the four phases of the project, there should be a continuous control and monitoring of the project. And you can find more information in the PM Square methodology. So to conclude, I would like to highlight that the key aspects of, to consider for a project to be successful are the use of standardized project management methodologies, the definition of the roles and responsibilities of the people involved, and to have very clear the four phases of the project lifecycle: the initiating, planning, executing, and closing. And with this, hopefully, like, there will be a successful of the project performance. If you need to know further information, please follow the links below, where you can find more references. And I hope this was very useful. Thank you so much for listening.